Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTagrity in San Antonio, Texas. And you know it, every single week I'm producing some sort of a video just like this for you to improve your online marketing around the world of WordPress. So if you're running a WordPress website, you also probably know if you've watched any of our videos here that I'm a super huge fan of this, Gravity Forms. It is a contact type of form, drag and drop builder plugin. It's amazing, mind blowing. If you want to learn more about it, we've got a whole playlist over here of videos that we've created on how to set up conditional logic, how to use it as a job board, how to set up payments with it, all sorts of cool stuff. So check out this playlist. I'll put the link to that in the description box below. But let's get to why you're watching this video. It probably is because you might have two forms on your single page or a post inside your website, and you're trying to get people to be able to easily tab using their tab option on their keyboard to tab through the fields. You know that this is best practice also for usability and accessibility, right? We want people to be able to click in a field and click their tab button and click over to this next field. It's really, really helpful for people. But if you're running two different forms on the same page, you're going to see the error that just happened right now. As I click here, look, check this out. So I've got two different forms happening on this one page. This form here, and then you see the submit button, and then a line, and you see that I'm running a totally separate form. These two forms are on the same page. They're both Gravity Forms. If I click tab, it unfortunately takes me all the way down here. It does not take me over to my next field, which would be my last name. So again, I'm in the first field and I click tab and it takes me all the way down here to my second form. It's very frustrating. So what is the fix? Is it super complicated? Do you have to write a lot of nerd code? Super easy, y'all. Check out this cool fix. This is all you have to do. You're gonna go into your form that you're gonna see here, and I'll let you see the visual side of it. So there's our short code for the first form, and then our line, the different form starts here, and that's our second form. What we need to do is give this one particular form its own tab index identifier. Ooh, sounds cool, it's pretty simple. So here's what we're gonna do. I'm gonna delete this for a second, and I want to add in that form again, and we're just gonna click add form. And it's the test for now, and I don't want the title, I don't need the description, but here's the trick. I want you to click this right here that says advanced options. This tab index, for now we're just gonna put the number 99 in there. Just throw that in there for now, and this is basically not important. We're not gonna worry about the action. You're just gonna type in 99 and click insert form. It's adding in this extended bit of nerd code in here into the short code that's gonna give this one form its own unique identifier. So I'm gonna click update. You don't need to give the other one, you can just give this one. I'm gonna click refresh over here. And now if my field is here and I click tab, I simply am able to tab through the entire form beautifully and easily, and the same thing with that one. That's it, it's called Tab Index. Check it out, throw it into your Gravity Forms, and rock and roll. I hope y'all are enjoying this, and if you are, please be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, because every week, every Wednesday, I'm producing some video just like this. If you need help, you can tweet me over at Corey Ashton on Twitter or at WebTagrity on Twitter. And if you need anything else, be sure to jump over to our website and send us an email. We'd love to be your nerd team support for all things WordPress. See you next week. Bye, y'all.